This is a recording of a public trance lecture given by the spirit guide Moon Trail through the mediumship of Horace Hambling, with whom he collaborated for 50 years. This lecture took place at the Spiritualist Association headquarters in London, England. And this lecture is entitled Good and Evil. The lecture is followed by questions from the audience. Preceding Moontrail, you will hear the voice of the Chinese guide Ruan Fo, who opens with prayer and who always acted as guardian to the medium during his deep trance state.
Divine celestial oversoul, whom we call Father, Mother God, in this moment we merely give word expression to the soul's desire, a desire that ever seeks to expand itself to embrace thee, as indeed thou dost embrace us, till in a consciousness of at-one-ment with thee, and thy wondrous power becomes in tune with us, there is a consciousness of collaboration, of sweet sharing of the task, of bringing thy universe into harmony in all its aspects. These earth children, still struggling upwards from the lowest realms of life, seek more than we do that measure of spiritual help and strength which will take them far along the pathway, so that when they join us, they will understand why it was we were always anxious to help them. Then too will they look backwards to help others. And in this long chain where humans hold the hands of humans, there will be a demonstration of the tirelessness of spirit to come up and up into thy wondrous consciousness. As today there comes more of this power earthwards by the visit of the Master Moontrail, so may they each take their full measure till the consciousness of peace dawns with them, and it stays with them now, and always, and always, and always. Lord Fo greets you, dear children, with much love. Hands the body of the instrument over to the Master Moontrail and says to you, thank you, and God bless you.
Ad majorem de gloriam. Not with vain tears when you're beyond the sun, you'll beat on the substantial doors, nor tread those dusty high roads with the aimless dead, plaintive for earth. But rather turn and run down some close-covered byway of the air. Stoop under the shadows, thread the gleams, and there find some whispering ghost-forgotten nook. And there spend pure converse in the eternal day. Think each in each immediately wise. Hear, know, and say all your tumultuous body now denies. And feel who've laid your groping hands away. And see, no longer blinded by your eyes. come earthwards to you, to speak to you, to mingle our spirits with yours, is Moon Trail's great joy at this moment. And coming close to Earth, we are aware of the necessity for such charity and love in all that we strive to present in the spoken word, that we have approached you, if you observe by the opening poem, on the inner planes rather than on the outer planes. In other words, within that opening poem is a plea that you will endeavor to think in us as we think in you. And thus we ought to become immediately wise. For the subject which has been chosen for us is one which is very inflammatory. If it has to be presented to large numbers of people who are unaccustomed to that which should be their truest knowledge, have not even begun to get on the fringe of it, still immersed in orthodox views of religion, still immersed in the muddy eddyings of politics, still immersed in the false search for happiness, still indeed asleep. To such people we oft-times bring much more volcanic and dynamic utterance than we feel we have need to on this occasion. And yet we know that each of you still has to be inwardly convinced of the true relationship of good and evil, and how these two opposites must be resolved to your happiness and comfort. You've heard us deal with it, most of you, and thus this becomes a reiterated talk. But we always believe that there is the odd person, the person who has not heard it, or the person who has come to us for the first time, or the questing student for truth, regardless as to from what source or who shall be the messenger striving to deliver it. Therefore, those of you who think you know what we are going to say, will, we are quite sure, show sufficient patience whilst we reiterate much that you've heard before. The subject was begun last week, we believe, where the wrong solution was first dealt with in this combat, which at least it has been represented to be by your pastors and masters, this combat between good and evil. But this time we turn to its opposite by the natural process of moving from negative to positive, and we are to consider the right solution. Now, they are two simple words, good and evil, and yet they form the main pillars underpinning the foundation of every religion. We think that the religious life of man sprang from his recognizing as the very first problem that confronted him this problem of good and evil. We think, we are not stating that as a fact, we have no signs in the Akashic records to prove that in the evolution of religion this problem was the beginning. Indeed, religion, as it has evolved through the ages, shows no signs at all of any proper roots at all. We suppose that's because it is not of importance. Akashic records, remember, are etheric impressions in rates of frequency above your printing machines, above your writing, above your recorded laws,